Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. So let's discuss about how to host our website in a local computer. Okay, till now what we did is we learned a front end language called HTML for constructing a web page. So afterwards, after constructing a web page, what is the next task? Next task is to make it available in the internet. Yes, right? So to do that, what we have to do? Okay, we need to make that web page which was constructed using HTML live. That means, what is the idea of constructing the web page? To share with somebody, okay, make it available to the world, right? So it may be the business task, or it may be the some organization or charity or etc. The idea of constructing the web page is to make it visible over the internet, right? So some way or the other, we need to make that web page, constructed web page, live, right? So let us understand first how to make a website live in our local computer. Okay, so even though in our last classes, in the earlier classes, we had set up one development server in the VS Code itself, right? That is called live server, okay? And then after studying forms, what we did is we set up one PHP server also, because to understand forms, so some backend script is needed, right? So for understanding that concept, we installed a PHP server separately, okay? So even though we had saw those live server and PHP server separately, now we are going to install one package, all-in-one package for web development purposes. So it's a good package, friends. So let's discuss about it. It is called XAMPP, right? So now we will see how to host a website or make our website live in our local computer. Okay? So step one, you need to download and install XAMPP from www.apachefriends.org/download.html. If you go to that link, so this XAMPP package will be available, friends. Okay, so let me show after explaining all this theory to you. So let's study some little concepts of XAMPP here. So XAMPP means, X means cross platform, so that this package is can be used in all Windows, Unix and Mac operating systems. So that is cross platform, that is the meaning of cross platform, friends. And A stands for Apache web server. Okay, so this package uses Apache web server. Okay, so what is the functionality, what is the work and what is the job of web server? It accepts the request and it sends the response. Okay, so it accepts the request from the web browser and it sends the response, okay, as a web page which it contains in its root directory. And then MySQL, now it is called MariaDB. So it's MySQL database server is also available inbuiltly in this package. Okay, in which we in the last classes in our live server or in PHP server, we doesn't have that one. If your script needs to connect to the database and you want to store some big data in a database, or you need to collect the data already stored in the database and present to the user, then MySQL is some database is needed to you. So in our exam, all these are readily available, friends. And then P stands for PHP scripting support. So web server is enough to receive the request from the web server and to serve the response. Okay, so in this web server, in its root directory, whatever we had constructed web pages in HTML will be placed in this web server root directory. So when our browser requests the web page, the web server first searches its root directory whether the page is available with me or not. If page is available, it will serve. That is the functionality of web server. That's it. Okay, if the requested user requested a file contains some access to the database, then we need PHP scripting or some language scripting to access to the database server, okay, which is inbuiltly this package is having, okay. And PHP scripting is also inbuiltly provided. We don't need to install everything separately, okay. So it is a all-in-one package. It's a full stack. So web server, database server, scripting layer, scripting language support, all will be integrated into one package, friends. Otherwise, we need to download each and every package separately, and we need to integrate all these three. Okay, Apache web server, database server, PHP scripting language, every thing we need to integrate. If we separately install this package separately, we need to integrate all these three, because every module has to communicate with each other. This web server has to communicate with the database server, so in between these two, the scripting layer must come. So all this we need to integrate together, right? We need to configure it manually, but in the XAMPP, all will have pre-installed and pre-configured. It's just, it's very easy. And let's read two notes which I have given here. XAMPP makes your local computer to act like a web server and database server with scripting support. So after installing your XAMPP, your computer will become a web server, friends, and a database server too, okay, with the scripting support. So your local computer, your laptop or your desktop will access a web server, because now your PC or laptop is having Apache web server. And then database server, because your PC is having MySQL database server in with you. And with scripting support, means PHP scripting support is also inbuiltly there in your computer. So all are available in XAMPP package. And then XAMPP is a good full stack web setup that suits only for development and testing of websites and web pages in our local computer, but it may not be suitable for real-time production environments. So let's understand these lines, friends. XAMPP is good and it suits for only testing and development purposes. That means if you are developing a website, right, so you need to test that website, okay, so first with your PC, then only you need to make it available publicly to the world, okay. Without testing, if you make it available to the public internet, then so much problems will come. If it is not properly configured and constructed, you need to change in the live environments, okay. So that is not recommended. So for that purposes, what everybody will do is, first a web developer makes his PC as a local web server, make it their computer as a web server, and then they construct HTML, CSS, JS, web pages, scripting pages with SQL support, everything they developed all the configuration files and put those configuration files in the root directory of the web server. Then they will request with their web browser. So all the things will be happened. So front end setup, back end setup, all are available in your laptop itself or desktop itself. Okay. So your web browser itself is a client side setup or front end setup. And the back end setup is this one, Apache web server, MySQL database, PHP support. All these three put together will become backend support, backend config, backend setup. Okay, so then all these are available now in your PC itself. In real time environments, the client is your laptop, that is your web browser. But the web server, database server, scripting supports, everything will be available at different place. Okay, whether in which place means it depends upon your hosting provider. Okay, that's a different topic. We will study that topic in the next classes. So let's understand this one. So XAMPP is for development purposes only and not for real time productions. Okay, so after that, after downloading this one, so next step is to install it. After installing, you can find an XAMPP folder in the C drive. If you installed in the C drive, then an XAMPP folder is created. You have to open it and then you find HTDocs folder. This HTDocs folder is the root directory, okay, of the web server. Whatever web pages you put into this HTDocs folder will be served. Okay, so if you construct a web page named say hello.html, and if you open the web server, web browser, and requested localhost /hello.html, then your web browser displays the hello.html. So this is the root directory, friends. It is very, very important. HTDocs is the root directory of the web server, Apache web server. Whatever web pages you put inside this, that web pages only be served. And then put your web pages to source code files in HTDocs folder. That is what I explained here. And then open web browser and type the web page name as shown below. Okay, after putting your web page's source code, that means HTML source code files in this HTDocs folder, you need to open your web browser and type the web page name. So whatever web pages you had placed inside the HTDocs folder, so you need to open your browser and type in order to access the web page which you have placed in this HTDocs folder. You need to type in your browser like localhost slash your web page name dot html. So let me explain this localhost. What is our localhost? Localhost means, because it is a development environment, we already discussed it, it is not a real. Okay, so in real environments, your web pages and has one site name. Okay, so you need to buy a domain name, you need to buy some hosting provider space from the hosting provider, and then you need to map your domain name with the hosting service providers. So much configuration will be there. But here, because our local computer itself is acting as a web server, we named it as localhost, because the host is our local computer only. Host means the web server. The web server is our local computer only. Okay, so in the real time environments, this localhost is replaced by the actual website name of our web pages. Okay, so in which our web pages will be located, right? So then this is a particular web page of interest you need to display in your website. And the other format of accessing your web page is also given by 127.0.0.1. This is called loopback address and it points to the local host. So both will work, friends. Okay. So this is the theory behind hosting a website in local computer. Let me explain this in practical now, friends. So I already made my own site, that is my the softwareservices.com, that is our site. For the demo purposes I had made that site available in my local computer. I will make it live now for demo purposes. Let me switch over to the setup, friends. So first we need to download XML, right? Okay, so open it. Okay, after opening it will come. So XAMPP for Windows, so you need to download according to your machine bit size. So after downloading, what is the next step, friends? What is the next step? Open XAMPP folder in C drive and then HD docs. Let me this PC. Okay, here you will find XAMPP folder will be there. So if you open that one, this is the all the packages, that means web server, database server. Okay, so here you can see this Apache is the web server, friends. And here you can see MySQL is the database server. So web server is there, database server is there, PHP, this is the scripting language support, and Perl also. Okay, so these are the scripting language supports is there. All are integrated already, say ready made full stack web development package, friends. And our point of interest is HD docs. This is the root directory, friends, very important. So whatever files you placed in this HD docs, that alone will be served. So now I had placed my the softwareservices.com website. It's our website. I had placed all that configuration files in this HD docs folder. Let me show it to you. So these files are the actual source code of our the softwareservices.com website, right? So this is the source code. So I personally designed this site for ourselves, friends. So in this HD docs, this is the HTML file names. Okay, so these are all the file names, HTML file tutorials, everything. Okay, so this index is some special meaning, friends. If you doesn't give any web page name after localhost, after typing localhost, if you doesn't give any web page name, then this index page will be the default page to open, friends. Okay, so this is like a home page. Okay, index page is a home page, friends. Let me show it to you, the source code. It's opening. Yes, yeah, this is the source code of our website, friends, the software services. So I had personally coded all these source code files for our site. So here you can see the author, the keywords, meta tags, okay, link tags, script tags, okay, so some CSS tags. So this is CSS styling and this navigation bars, everything. Okay, this is the source code. So the what I am trying to tell is, after building your web pages like this, you need to put all your web pages in this htdocs folder. Okay, so then what? Then you need to do what? Okay, the step 3 is also over. Then step 4, open web browser and type the web page name you want. Okay, let us open, and then local host. Okay, I am not giving the any web page. That means home page will open. That means index page will open. Boom. Yeah. This is our website, friends. Right? So, TSS. A knowledge sharing. A web portal for knowledge sharing. So, this is our home page, friends. This is our website, the software services, which is hosted locally. Now this actual source code is working in my laptop. For the demo purposes, I placed all the source code in my laptop exam htdocs root folder. So that's why it is serving, it is appearing as a local host. Okay, so all the functionalities is appearing here. This is my job roles, my skill set. So that is my contacts here. So developed by Veera Raghavath. It is some footer. This is header. Okay, so this is a our site logo. This is some data science tutorials, Python basics, Python advanced. Okay, so whenever you click this one, a separate page is opening. So that page is also working in localhost only. So that separate page name is, you can see, python_basics_tutorials.html. Okay, this source code is different. Okay, so the video comes up. Okay, learn Python basics to become a Python developer. If you click this one, the YouTube video can play. And so the same YouTube videos which you watched in youtube.com will be available here also. So all the playlist will be there. Okay, not a single video, all the playlist of Python basics will be available. If you click this one, the playlist will be available here. Okay, so all the playlists, some 65 playlists will be open here, right? So this is the concept. Okay, running a web page locally. So if you click this Python advanced, it will be available here. So all these web pages are available, friends. Okay, Python advanced tutorials. If you open this htdocs here, you can see Python basic tutorials. This is the web page I designed. Let me open this one and show you the source code of this particular tutorials.html. This is also header and footer is same for every web page, but the content will change. So this is the content iframe. I had embedded our YouTube video series using iframe tag. Okay, so this is the concept. If you click that one, that web page will be appeared. I had used anchor tags for that. Let me show it, that thing to you. So this is the anchor tag, right? So one minute, let me explain to you. Okay, so Python basic tutorials anchor tag. So if you click this Python basics in the menu, it will internally directed towards to Python basic tutorials.html because we have used anchor tag here, right? Okay, so everything is working fine. And like that, if you click that NumPy videos will come. Okay, so like that HTML5. Okay, HTML5 is video available. All this is hosted from local only. And since my laptop is connected to internet, that's why YouTube videos are loading. So this is the basics of hosting a website in your local computer. And one more thing is, I want to show it to you is, so this is a web server doing it, okay? Our Apache web server is doing it. So whenever you want to contact with the inbuilt database, then our XAM has a super support PHP MyAdmin support will be there. It is loading here. If you XAM package is having admin panel, okay, this is the admin panel in which we will view the databases, okay. So here we have databases, some Google, My Database, MySQL, the soft BSNL, all these ones. So if you click this one, these databases will appear here, okay. It's all in one package, friends, okay. So it's a very good package for developing side. If you want to run queries, SQL queries, you can write here, okay. So like that. So this is the process, friends, right? So and in the next class we will discuss how to host a website in the internet, okay. So now we saw and learned how to host website in our local computer for development testing purposes. In the next class we will discuss how to host a website in real-time environments, okay. So that means it will be available to the public worldwide, right? Okay friends, till then, bye bye. Your Sweera signing off. Thank you for listening.